my channel, so I was not able to upload any video for quite some time. It's because I was a little busy. I had to make a few visits to the hospital. But today I finally found out some time and decided to shoot. So today's video is going to be a book review video. I just completed reading Train to Pakistan by Khushwant Singh. Now I'm having this book with me for quite a few years. I purchased it when I was in my college. And the reason I got attracted to this book is because it talks about the days of partition. Now, partition of India is something that has always attracted me. I always get surprised that how a nation where people of all religion who fought against a common enemy, Britain, suddenly started feeling that they are each other's enemy. How come they suddenly started feeling that they have life threats from each other? Was it actually there, or it was just a well-fed political phenomena? So that is the reason why I purchased this book. But due to some reasons, I was never able to finish it. Every time I used to start it, I used to leave it after reading like 10 to 12 pages. I don't know why. But now that I am constrained from doing many things, I decided to read all my unread books, and this is the first book that I have completed. So let's just start with the review. Now, the story of the books takes you back to the days of partition and the entire country is burning in the fire of partition. But there are still some places which are in peace, and one such place is Mano Majra. It's a small village situated on the border of newly formed India and Pakistan. So the people over here are away from all the communal disputes, and this is the village around which our story revolves. Now, the population of this village mainly comprises of the Muslims and the Sikhs, but the landlord of this village, Ramlal, he is a Hindu. So the people over here, they consider each other's brother. There is no communal dispute. But suddenly everything changes when Ramlal is murdered, his house is looted, and after a few days, a train carrying thousands of dead bodies of Sikhs arrives from Pakistan. Now suddenly these peace-loving people who consider each other brothers, they turn hostile towards each other. They started feeling that they have life threats from the people of other religion. They started feeling that the people of other religion have always oppressed them in the past. They started telling the stories how the Gurudwaras were demolished by the Muslims, and Muslims started saying how their Qurans were being burned by the Sikhs. So everything changes over a night. People really don't know what has happened, but the stories travel so fast in the village. So the story doesn't talk much about the political things going on in the country. It basically focuses on the common man, their lifestyle, and what was their thought process. And it beautifully depicts that how only the religion, caste, and the parentage were the only aspects to judge someone's character. It also shows that how easily a common man could be manipulated, how easily they can be threatened, how easily their hearts could be corrupted. So it's a very beautiful book, and the best part about this book is that it completely remains unbiased towards any religion. And the best thing what I liked about this book is this cover page. I think it really justifies the story, like this ghostly looking train coming somewhere from Pakistan, I think. And apart from that, the language of the book is also quite easy to understand. You don't need to pull out dictionary. Even if you don't know the meaning of some words, you can just continue. And another fact is it's not very fat. You can easily complete it. It's around 200 pages or something. The only thing I didn't like about this book is that the story remains a little slow in the starting, and that is the reason I think why I was not able to complete it in the first places. So the story is little slow in the starting, but it takes pace eventually. So if you're looking for something light and still worthy of reading, then you should definitely give this book a try. It's a nice read. So yeah, that's all about the book. If you have any suggestions for me, you can write down in the comment section below. I will love to read books. I'm in my reading phase right now. And yeah, that's all. So if you like this video, like it, share it, and subscribe to my channel. Do all that good stuff. And see you next time. Bye.